I hope that your IBPS PO preparation is going very well. In this video, we are going to take a deep dive into the IBPS PO mains preparation. If you have any questions, you have any doubts, let me know in the comments below and I'll try to help you out. If you are looking for a course that will help you comprehensively to cover all of these topics, give you a lot of mock tests and study notes and all the important live classes you need to get success in this examination, you can check out GuideLease Express video course and you can get a 10% off on their course by using the coupon code SHUPRIO. Let's take a closer look into the IBPS PO mains preparation strategy. Hi, this is SHUPRIO. So the IBPS PO mains preparation. So many people do not understand that prelims and mains must be prepared in a completely different manner. We have to always remember that prelims is just like a 100 meter race. It is about who crosses the finish line fastest, who just picks up speed very, very fast, and it's very, very easy. But mains is a lot different. Mains is all about a marathon. So you must have the stamina. You must have a long-term approach. You must be able to correct your course. And there are a lot of finer things that we are discussing in this video so that you get to understand how IBPS PO mains preparation will be happening correctly. So the first thing that you need to remember is that you have to change your approach. Many people get stuck on this. They are preparing for mains in the same manner. So as I said, it is a marathon and you need to have marathon work sessions. So whenever you are doing main-centric preparation, try to keep your work sessions very long. So at least 3 to 4 hours, try to sit and then solve sums and do not take any break between this time. Because in the mains paper, you have to actually sit down for 3.5 hours continuously in front of a computer screen. This is something that people just do not understand. They might be reading from books, they might be doing some other activities while they're preparing, but if you do that, then you are telling your brain that it is okay to take a break. But in the mains paper, you cannot take any break. It will be a very difficult paper, that is for sure, and this year with the vacancies being less, it will be even more difficult. So you must teach your brain to actually concentrate for that amount of time. And of course, you should be also knowing when you are going to start your mains preparation. Now many people, they delay their mains preparation and after their prelims has gone well, they are celebrating. But remember, just finishing off prelims is a simple small battle. The war is still left. So you have to actually pull yourself together and you have to prepare for mains. So the first thing that you need to do is from day one of your preparation, the GA preparation, the general awareness, it will be continuing. And in the initial weeks, you can do a few mains mock tests. But after the prelims actually gets over, the very next day, you have to focus entirely on the mains preparation. Now, this time, the dates are such that for mains, you are going to get a lot more time than normally you get, and that is why you have to use this time very, very well. If you are finished off with your prelims, don't give yourself any breaks. Always jump into the mains preparation and you should be starting it as early as possible. So remember that very, very well. And you have also got to create a winning formula. Now many people, they do not create this winning formula inside their mock tests. This is the key area where you have to create this formula. When you are giving your mock test, you will be understanding the question types which are easier for you to actually solve. When you find that out, that is the kind of strategy that you have to go towards when you are finally just sitting for your mains examination. So remember, this winning formula that I am talking about, it will be very specific to you. So you will be understanding which question types are easier for you to do. And so it has to be tailor-made to your strengths and weaknesses. The person who will be understanding his or her strength and weakness will be excelling in this examination. So it's not only about doing mocks continuously. I have seen so many people, they are only giving mocks and they are not analyzing themselves. You have to understand yourself. That is the most important tool to get success in mains examinations. And another thing is that, are you prepared for surprises? Now many people, when they sit for this examination, they will have a frame of mind that I will be attacking this questions, I will be doing it in this manner, and suddenly the question paper will be so tough that they will be depressed, they will be very, very surprised, and they will not be able to attack the questions properly. So you must have
this kind of a mentality that the question paper is always going to surprise you, except for perhaps the GA and the banking awareness section, the GA section. The other sections, they can easily confuse you, they can easily throw you random questions, and this is up to you how you tackle those questions. So always be ready for any kind of surprise. I am telling you right now that this exam will throw many surprises, and the people who will be ready for it will be excelling. And the next thing is the importance of simulation. You have to build up your cognitive endurance. So what is this cognitive endurance? It means that when you are sitting for that 3.5 hours, your brain is working perfectly. So you have to be able to simulate your environment. So just remember that when you get the timings for your tests, you are sitting for tests in that point of time. So if you have your test from 10 a.m., just try to give your mocks from 10 a.m. And like this, you have to practice, because then your brain will be active during that time and it will not fall asleep. We do not want to be less active at those points of time. So simulation is very important. When you are sitting for your mocks, make sure that you have the exam environment. I have seen so many people who will be taking breaks in their mocks, and they are the ones who will later be complaining ki prelims to ho raha hai but mains nahi ho raha hai. So don't be those type of people. Just always try to remember these points. And coming to the IBPS PO mains breakdown, so I will be telling you how you are going to approach. Now understand the pattern first. So you have reasoning, 45 questions worth 60 marks, 60 minutes will be given to you. So 1 hour is allocated for reasoning. Now this time allotted for each test, you are understanding these are sectional timings. So sectional timings mean that you cannot navigate out of this section for 1 hour. So for 1 hour it will be locked, and any section can come at the beginning, though the pattern is usually in this following order, but still any section can come first. So you must be very much prepared. And then you have the general awareness, which is for 40 marks, which has 35 minutes. Then you have the English language, 40 marks, 40 minutes, and the data analysis and interpretation, the quant section, you have 35 questions worth a maximum of 60 marks for 45 minutes. And then you have the English language, the descriptive part, the letter writing and essay. So that will be again 30 minutes and you have 25 marks. Now, just looking at this pattern, can you tell me which is the section that carries the most weight? Just try and find out. Have you identified that it is not actually the other sections, but it is the English language section? Why is this? This is because English language has 40 marks in the objective paper, and also in the descriptive you have 25 marks. So a total of 65 marks will be for English language only. Now understand that each of these sections you have to pass, right? You have to get the minimum marks in these sections. So in 2019, if we analyze the sectional cutoff, the past year cutoff, then in the reasoning paper, it was 7.75. It was a hard paper. So out of 60 marks, the cutoff was 7.75. And these are all general cutoffs I am talking about. The SC, ST, OBC, they are a little bit different, lower, not more than this. So this is the maximum amount of marks, the maximum cutoff. And the general awareness, it was 8 marks for the general awareness and banking awareness. And for the English language C, it was 14.25. So in English, everybody had concentrated quite a lot. So understand that the highest cutoff went for English because it was the easiest paper and people had focused also a lot. And then you have the quant paper, which was 5.25, and the descriptive paper, which was 10. So the overall cutoff that you have, it was 71.25. Now, what does this tell you? See, the total amount of marks that you have to secure, 200 over here and 25. So it will be 225 marks in 3.5 hours, right? So out of 225, you only have to secure 71.25. Let us consider 80, not more than 80. It usually happens. So around 80 to 85, you will be safe in most of these papers. So if you have to get around 80, can you understand that if your English is very, very good, then you are getting 40 marks over here, then you are getting 25 marks over here. So that alone gives you 65 marks. And then when you are good in general awareness, you have 40 more marks. So you have 105 marks in just general awareness and the English skills. So if you are good in these two sections, you are far ahead of the pack. And remember that if you are somebody who is good in English and you can actually manage the GA paper, then you do not need to be good in reasoning and quant as well. You can pick either reasoning or quant and be good in any one of those subjects, because the most of the marks you will already have secured, and in the reasoning and DI, you have to just find out the cutoff marks. You have to just secure some minimum amount of marks. So this is a great strategy for people who are very strong in English. Now, what happens if you are not strong in English? Then you have to do it a little differently. You have to pick out a section that will be easier for you. So either focus on reasoning or on quant. Both of them will be giving you 60 marks. So any one you have to become very, very strong at. And I have seen mostly people target the quant section because it is much more predictable. And I have seen that harder data interpretation is easier to do than harder puzzles, but it might be different for you. So just plan accordingly. And after that, the general awareness, if you can do it, so 100 marks, you are almost secure. And the rest of the things, you have to just get your minimum cutoff marks, which is easy to actually secure. But I will still say that if you can, just focus on English, because it will be a very important factor in your success. And even in the interviews, you can sit for the interview either in English or in Hindi. So if you are good in English, then you can secure those interview marks very, very easily as well. So this is the kind of overall strategy, the overall breakdown that you need to follow. And always remember that the paper is going to be hard. It is a no-brainer. The IBPS mains difficulty has increased over the years, and in this year I do not expect any different. This will be a hard paper. So I will be going into the sectional breakdown. You will be understanding. This was the overall strategy. And always remember, cognitive endurance is very, very important. Teach your brain to be active for 4 hours at a stretch, at least 3.5 hours. You have to be active. And when you are giving your mock test, sit for that time. Just even if you don't have your descriptive paper, in many mocks it will not be there. Then also, after your paper ends, for 30 minutes, sit and write down some essay and letter. Then you will be having that exact exam experience in your mock tests. And of course, the normalization will also come into play. So this marks that you secure out of 225, they will be converted into 80 marks. So this 225, it is normalized to 80, and the rest 20 marks, it will be from the interview. So 100 marks will be the interview, and out of that, they will be normalizing it to 20 marks. So if you want a session on interviews, let me know. I will definitely make a different video on that. We have a lot more time, so we can discuss about it later on. So this is the overall strategy, and I hope that you got an idea how you can approach this paper, how you can best tackle this paper. Now coming to the mains sectional strategy for your reasoning and your computer aptitude. Now usually I might sometimes tell you the targets for these papers, but in this paper I do not want to tell you any target, because the question paper will be very, very out of our expectations, and so we do not understand what is the main target that we can go for. But of course, out of 60 marks you can easily target 30 plus if you are moderately good at reasoning and you can do a few puzzles. So don't be disheartened if your marks are low, because I showed you just now the sectional cutoff will be remaining very low, so no need to worry about that. And just remember that this reasoning practice for your mains preparation will be a little different from your prelims. So you have to practice the long-winded critical reasoning questions. Critical reasoning will be playing a vital part, for especially for people who are not that good in puzzles. So if you are just average at puzzles, you can tackle those critical reasoning very, very well. But the problem is that in most mock tests, these types of questions are not properly given to you. But still, you have to just practice some identify assumptions type of questions, the strong or weak arguments, the cause and effect questions, the draw conclusions, the inference, the assumptions, the statements and assumptions, those questions, and the course of action. So these types of long-winded questions, so get good at reading speed. I have already told you that reading will be very, very important to develop. And also try and use some flowcharts in your rough sheet when you are solving these papers, because there will be questions which will have multiple clauses. So clause 1, clause 2, clause 3, if you can just diagrammatically just represent it in the form of a flowchart in your rough sheet, it will be much easier for you to get through this paper. And then you have to do the mains mocks. So mains mocks will be very, very important for the coded inequalities, the coding decoding, the machine input output, the blood blood relations, the direction questions and other compound questions that can come. So two, three things will be mixed together and the question will be made a little bit difficult. So if you are looking for very high quality mock tests, then you can check out Guidelease Express video course. They have a complete coverage of prelims and mains mocks. They will be giving you live classes, study notes and all the important things you need to get a proper guidance for this examination. They have a separate Telegram group to help you out, and they will also be refunding all your money if you get selected in any examination. You can use the coupon code Supriyo to get a 10% off on their Express video course, and I hope that this mock test will be very beneficial to you. So of course, mains mock tests, they are very vital. Many people say that there are not any importances to the mock tests in the mains paper, but it cannot be farther from the truth. If you have good mock tests and you practice them regularly, you are getting into the examination flow. And I have also already explained how you are going to analyze the mock test. So if you have not checked that video, go check it out. It will be helping you tremendously to understand how you can actually just go forward with your analysis. And of course, the puzzles, they are the most important thing in the reasoning paper, and many people are very, very confused. So my advice, my main fundamental advice is that you have to choose the right puzzle. If you are choosing the wrong puzzle, then that will be game over. I have sometimes made a mistake. I have actually chosen difficult puzzles, and that has completely ruined my reasoning paper. So don't make the same mistake like I did. Always be very sure that you will be able to solve this puzzle and leave the puzzles till the end. At the beginning, try and do the coded inequalities, the coding decoding, the blood relations, the directions, whatever else you have. Then go for the critical reasoning, the long questions that you have to read, and finally move towards the puzzles, because almost all puzzles in mains will be having some kind of twist. So don't risk it. And then also about the computer questions. So they mention computer aptitude over here, but it is a big lie. There is no computer aptitude. There will only be some flowchart type of questions. Maybe at best they will give you some kind of conversions of hexadecimal, octal, binary, and at most the computer science related things. There will be no MS Word, no MS Excel, no PowerPoint, no nothing like that. So don't waste your time. Those are things that are asked in RRB examinations. So don't worry about that. So that is all about your reasoning mains sectional strategy. Now coming to the sectional strategy for your general economy and banking awareness. Now this is a section of the paper that will be very easy for you to tackle, because this is highly predictable. Almost every year we can understand what type of questions come. So here I will be giving you a target. It will be 30 plus. Try and get even 35 plus. Some people get that also. So secure as many marks as possible. And this section, when you are sitting for it, it will usually not take you that long. So in 10 minutes or 15 minutes you will be finishing it, and then just give your brain some rest. Once you have done with the questions and you have revised it and you have seen that you have no more to attempt, just close your eyes and have a little bit of rest, because the next sections, before they come, you cannot navigate to them. So you have to wait. So this is a great time to just get your energy up to that level, and then you can attack the rest papers. So that is something that you have to do while you are practicing the mocks as well. And the daily general awareness practice, this is something I have always told you. So go ahead and practice the daily general awareness. It's going to be invaluable for this section, and you have to choose any one source for your daily prep. Now I have made a complete video on the general awareness, so I'm not going into detail about it. Go check it out if you have any doubts regarding how you want to proceed with this section. And you have to supplement your daily preparation with the monthly PDFs that we have already talked about. Now how much GA to study? This is also a question that many people ask me. So this time the mains, it is going to be on 28th November, right? So since that is the time, 1 week before the exam, you have to at least get your GA done. So up to 21st November, you have to read GA. Now, many people will tell you that you don't have to read till that late. But let me assure you that sometimes IBPS has asked questions just a few days before. So even 6 to 7 days before the exam, some GA was there and they had asked them in the question. So up to 21 November, it is very important to study. So from 1st August, 1st August to 21 November. Just try and read as much as possible. So this is going to be your key focus area. This is the part of the GA preparation that has to be very, very solid for you. So do not compromise in this preparation. And then you have to go till 1st of June. So till 1st of June, that will be your deadline. Before 1st of June, no need to cover. From 1 June to 21 November, you can cover, and that will be enough with your general awareness preparation. Always cover the latest months first and then move towards the earlier months. Always do it in that manner. And of course, the banking awareness. This is something that people I have seen always neglect, because in the mains paper, to be honest, banking awareness does not come too much. There will be only a few questions, but in your interview, banking awareness is essential. That is why I have created a full course on banking awareness. It is still ongoing. You can go check it out. It will be very, very helpful for you. It will allow you to understand the various complicated concepts in a very easy manner. So go check it out, and it will be helpful for your mains preparation. But most importantly, it will be helpful for your interview. Now, the main sectional strategy for your English language, that is also very, very important. As I told you, English, if somebody can master, they will be a master of the IBPS PO mains examination. Now, start with an RC. This is always very important for your mains preparation. The reading comprehension, the easiest one you have to pick. So minimum 3 reading comprehensions will be there in the exam. So pick the one that is most comfortable, and sometimes there will be a little bit more, but at least one will be there which is very easy to actually cover. And then there are two methods after you can do your first RC. So after you do the first RC, what you can do, you can move to the other RCs as well, and you can solve them, because each will be having 5 questions and it will be very easy to cover all those things very, very fast. But if you are not that good at reading, then you can go for the other general questions. So go for the closer test, the fillers, the different other types of English questions. But this will actually be depending on the difficulty of your paper. So if the paper is very, very difficult, then sometimes it makes sense to go for the RC. So be very flexible in this and understand that the paper can throw many surprises at you, and the level that will be there, it will be higher than you expect. So even if you are good in English, let me assure you that this exam will be testing your limits. So do not at all feel that this can be an easy section to cover. And of course, do not ignore the descriptive practice. So each week, try to do at least at the minimum 1 essay and 1 letter every week. At least if you can do 2 or 3, it will be much better if you are not that strong. But if you are good at English, then at least 1 essay and 1 letter you can cover. And do not neglect descriptive, because those 25 marks, they can make a difference. Some people have gotten above 20 in that section and they have been selected despite not performing well in the objective part. So descriptive can be a savior for many, many people. Never neglect it. And of course, the fillers, the closer test, the column match. So column match is also there, where there will be 2 different columns and you have to match which sentences will be lining up. So these types of complicated questions will be there, not the easy ones that you see in the prelims. There will be some compound questions, and it will be necessary to read a lot. So make sure that you just attempt it very carefully, and also look at the marks distribution. Sometimes some questions in English will have more marks, maybe 1.5, 1.75. So be very careful and choose those questions. Those will increase your chances so much. And of course, there will be jumbled sentences, words and passages. So these questions I put at the lowest priority. So only after most of the other things are done, I will be moving to those questions. So you can do it in that manner. Moving on to the data analysis and the data interpretation section. So this quant section, it will also be something that is not easy to crack, but there will be a DI which will be one of the easier ones. Even if it is not easy, it will be less hard than the other DIs. So try and find out that DI which is doable. Usually a minimum of 4 or 5 DI will be there, and at least 1 or 2 will be easy for you to do. So calculative DI is not the hard DI. This is something you need to understand in your mains preparation. Even if the calculation is a lot more, it might be that that DI is quite easy. And I have also noticed something in the mains paper, that sometimes there will be 5 questions, right? 3 of them will be very easy and 2 will be very hard. So don't waste your time in the remaining 2. Don't feel that just because I have picked this DI, I have to completely finish this DI. That is a wrong approach. You have to find easy questions, not only the easy DIs. So if you have some easy questions, go for it. And the hard ones, just keep it aside. And later on, you can, of course, come back when you are done with the most other questions. So you can sometimes do the missing DI very easily if you can retabulate. So just write down those tables in your own rough sheet, and it will be helping you a lot to actually ace this section. And of course, there will be some charts that you need to understand. So candlestick charts, remember that you have to know how these work, the radar graphs, the spider charts, etc. So different types of charts, you can go ahead and you can just read and you will understand a lot better. And the tabular, the line graph, the bar chart, the pie chart, mixed DIs, the caselet DIs as well, which have a lot of reading to do. So sometimes these things, they might not be that difficult. So read through the exact problem, and if you feel it is possible to do, then go ahead and do it. Don't keep it till the end. So DIs will be the most important keys to your success in this. So do as many DIs as possible, and in the Telegram channel that I have, I'll also try to give you some more DIs so you can practice some mains level DI. And the number series and the arithmetic, now these questions will be a little bit twisted in your mains paper. So number series, they might be giving you 3 or 4, and after solving 3 or 4, you might have to arrange the missing numbers, and it will be a little lengthy. So lengthy arithmetic and lengthy number series you can expect, so make sure that you practice those. And the main centric DIs, as I told you, very very important that you practice as much mains focused DIs as possible. And reading skills will come into play, that we have already talked about. You have to be good at reading because there will be a lot of text in most questions of mains, and you have to just interpret it properly. Now coming to the final advice, I think this quote is something that all of us need to remember. I fear not the man who has practiced 10,000 kicks once, but I fear the man who has practiced one kick 10,000 times. Who said this? This was said by none other than Bruce Lee. Now, this means that in the mains examination, you have to be an expert at what you are solving. So it's not important that you have to be an expert in everything, but the things that you have actually studied, make sure that you are thorough with them. Even complicated things you can do. So if you have studied the average chapter, make sure that all the questions, all the concepts are in your mind, because these questions in the mains paper will be testing your concepts. So cover one thing very, very well. That should be your main motto. And of course, the daily mini goals, very important. You have to have specific and measurable goals. So I would suggest that keep a journal, and in the morning, write down that I have to finish this chapter. I have to do 25 questions of this chapter. I have to get this concept. And at the end of the day, do the EOD analysis that I always talk about, end of day analysis. And also at the end of the week, do the EOW analysis, the end of week analysis, to understand where you went right and where you went wrong. This is going to be very helpful for you in the long term. And there is also the value of momentum that you need to understand, that when you are in the habit of cracking exams becomes very easy. So once you have cracked a few prelims, then you will see that most of the prelims you are cracking. And once when you start cracking the mains paper, you will see that the other mains paper also becomes very easy. So once you are very well versed in cracking one exam, the other exams follow. So always try and have that kind of a mentality when you are sitting for the exams. Even if you are sitting for other exams, if you can have that momentum carry forward, then that momentum alone can actually help you succeed in this examination. And the number of mocks now. So many people ask me, how many mocks is ideal? Now this will depend totally on you. There is no magic number. I have seen people succeed with 5 mocks. I have seen people fail with even 50 mocks. Mocks are only for understanding where you are going wrong. So you have to actually first analyze your strength and weaknesses. And if you can analyze it in 5 mocks, then also you can get good marks, right? So that is why don't focus on number of mocks, but on the quality of mocks and on the analysis of mocks. So this is very important. And don't have the victim mentality about the cutoff. I have seen so many people who say that if the cutoff was lower, I would have made it. If that person who had cracked that exam had not sat for this exam, then I would have made it. I have seen too many people say that, and that is a victim mentality. Don't feel that you can succeed because the other person has to fail. Don't have that zero-sum mentality. This is a zero-sum mentality, and it is very, very bad. Always have the mentality that I have to be better than that person. that person does not have to be worse, I have to be better. This will cause a radical change in your thinking if you can implement it. And at the end, always remember your mental and physical fitness both are important. So don't be a person who is all the day studying and they are not going out. Try and go outside if you can in this situation, in this pandemic situation. Sometimes it can be hard, but I urge you to go outside around your house also. If you can walk, if you can get some exercise, it will be very good. And try and do meditation. That can help you to ease those anxieties, and this time is very difficult. There are so many difficulties out in the real world, so internally you have to be at peace. Keep yourself fit and keep yourself active, and I am sure that if you are putting in your honest hard work, there is nobody that can stop you. I hope that you have learned something from this video and that it was beneficial to you. If you enjoyed this session, please leave a like and share it with your friends. And if you want to see more of this kind of content, please click on the subscribe button and do not forget to click the bell icon so that you, my friend, do not miss any future update. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.